Unlike women, healthy men constantly produce sperm in their testicle almost throughout their lifespan. The testicle are ball-like structures and is responsible for the production of sperm. The production of sperm is triggered at puberty due to the presence of testosterone. Testosterone is secreted by some special cells in the testes, and these special cells are called Leydig cells. Leydig cells ensure that there is a constant production of sperm, and so testosterone is responsible for the development of secondary sexual characteristics, and it maintains libido in men. The activity of these cells declines around the age of 40 to 50, and that will lead to a male menopause or andropause as we know it. So if there is a reduction in the level of this hormone, that will lead to male infertility alongside with things like aging, and aging brings with it an increase in DNA damages that would cause an increase in genetic mutation and also developmental problems in your offspring. My name is Kingsley Ojukwu, and this is Easy IVF. Approximately 100 to 300 million sperm is produced every day, like every single day. We men make a lot of sperm cells, whereas women typically ovulate one egg per month. A normal ejaculate would contain about roughly 50 million to 200 million sperm cells. That's a lot, right? And it takes only one sperm to achieve a healthy pregnancy. Simple as this may sound, I mean, there are many factors that can affect the quality of the sperm and the ability to fertilize an egg. So basically, you might have an ejaculate that is this much, but the truth of the matter is it's empty. There's nothing in it. There is no sperm cell in it. Or there could be sperm cells in there, and they could be morphologically defective, and they're not capable of fertilizing an egg. So the question I get asked is, why should I freeze my sperm when my body makes a lot of sperm cells? The answer is because not all the cells your body make is morphologically correct. So here are the top 10 reasons why you should freeze your sperm. 1. Medical reasons. Cancer is a bitch, and radiotherapy and chemotherapy can affect the quality of your sperm post-treatment. And just because of the effect of these chemicals and radiation on your body, they will kind of kill off all the sperm cells you have. Down the line, there is a possibility that your sperm cells and your sperm count would be normal, but 1 to 2 years after your treatment, your sperm cell is next to nothing. So it's recommended you freeze your sperm before starting any cancer treatment. And it only takes like a wank, just jerk off and have that sperm cells frozen. If you're undergoing a prostate surgery, it might be wise that you freeze your sperm for the future. Things like erectile dysfunction, or if you have no ejaculate at all, there is a procedure whereby a surgeon can actually biopsy some of your cells, testicular cells, from your scrotum, and you know, an embryologist or a lab scientist would kind of like dig out some sperm cells from that biopsy, and they are able to now find some active motile sperm in that tissue and then freeze that for future use. The second reason why I think you should freeze your sperm is aging and family planning. The sperm you freeze in your 20s is less likely to carry genetic mutation than the one you freeze when you are 40. For family planning, most heterosexual couples these days wait about 3 to 4 years before they start having kids after they get married. Whereas homosexual couples, on the other hand, they wait a longer period of time because of the obstacles they face when they are trying to have kids. So the wait times in some cases can be as much as 5 to 10 years. And if you freeze your sperm now, you're able to use it down the line when the time comes. 3, occupational freezing. Occupational freezing, we can kind of like talk about this topic in two different ways. Those people that have direct contact with some stuff that would, you know, kind of like affect their fertility, and the ones that have indirect contact. So if you have a direct contact, such as like if your job exposes your scrotum to extreme temperatures, So if you're a long distance driver, because you sit on that chair for a long period of time and the heat that you create between your balls and the chair, it kind of like takes a toll on your sperm count, you should consider freezing your sperm. If you're a welder and you're close to heat, because you have direct contact to extreme temperatures, you should also consider freezing your sperm. Farmers, painters, those people who are exposed to extreme pesticides, a lot of pesticides, they should also consider freezing your sperm. For those that have indirect contact, such as men in the military, you know, pilots, people who are kind of building their career and they do not have time to start a family, you know, once you've accepted that position to be in the force, to fight for your country, and you don't have a family, you should just freeze your sperm and try and negotiate with your government or try and negotiate with your employer to pay for the cost of freezing. It doesn't cost them more than $1,000, you know, per person. Five, before having a vasectomy. Most of the times, men find themselves in a situation where they know or think that they are ready to stop having kids. Say, for example, someone, you're married and you have three kids and you think, you know what, I am done. I should just cut off this stuff and have fun. But the fact is that down the line, you can never predict what's going to happen. Most of the times, things like divorce and death can actually change the waves of things, right? Can actually make things change. And when you find yourself divorced and then marrying someone else who wants to have a kid, the cost of having your sperm frozen could be cheaper than having a vasectomy reversed. Although the success rate for the reversal is as high as 90%, the pregnancy rate, however, could be as low as 40%. Whereas the pregnancy that you have using an IVF is just under 15%. So having a vasectomy reversal and IVF can extremely be expensive, whereas having an intrauterine insemination with the sperm you froze before you had the vasectomy can be as cheap as $1,000. So consider freezing your sperm before having your line cut, because like reversing it can be expensive and it also can reduce the success of your pregnancy, and that will also subject your partner to in vitro fertilization. Number six, lifestyle. Your lifestyle can be indicative of whether or not you need to freeze your sperm. It's just, you know, in these days, it's not just moms who needs to abstain from alcohol when considering having a child. Alcohol can lower the testosterone we talked about. If alcohol lowers the testosterone levels, then it would affect the sperm quality, which would consequently affect your fertility. So if you love drinking heavily and also want to have kids in the future, consider freezing your sperm now, and then live the kind of life you want. If your sperm is affected, you have a backup in the bank. Seven, financing and family dynamics. Egg freezing might be no option for your family when considering fertility preservation. If your partner, who is a woman, cannot freeze her eggs, you as a guy should be able to freeze your sperm just in case something happens to any of you. Because sperm freezing is obviously way cheaper than egg freezing. Number eight, individuals transitioning to another gender. So before transitioning from a male to a female, consider freezing your sperm to have options in the future. It's very possible that you wouldn't need to use that sperm. And it's also very possible to fall in love with someone and wished you saved your sperm. There are a lot of articles on this subject if you're interested in reading them. Just consult with your doctor or your surgeon and ask him or her about the options of freezing your sperm before transitioning. Nine, altruistic reason. There are millions of families out there that are struggling with male infertility, and a lot of them do not have the financial capability to obtain free sperm samples from the bank. Even when they do, there's a lack of diversity in the sperm bank for people looking to have kids of their cultural origin, right? So another reason to be an altruistic donor is, I mean, if you don't want to father kids, it would be good to know there is a progeny of you somewhere running around, you have a child somewhere, but you are not directly involved in that care. You can also consider donating your sperm to the LGBTQ2 community. There are a lot of women in same-sex relationship looking for a sperm donor. You can contact them on so many platforms and just help them achieve their dreams. Things you should know about donating your sperm in Canada is that if you're donating your sperm for altruistic reasons in Canada, some of the clinics may not be able to accept your sample because the donation tank they have is full, and some clinics may not be able to accept your sample because they are obliged or they are mandated to keep a record of every donor so that they can be tracked down the line. So basically, you cannot be an anonymous donor. So some clinics find this law kind of very rigmatic, and they just do not want to accept donor samples except the one the patient brings by themselves. Finally, the 10th reason why you should freeze your sperm is for financial gains. In some countries like Canada, as mentioned, it's illegal to donate your sperm for pay, whereas in the US and other parts of the world, you are financially compensated for your sperm. I mean, that being said, you will still have to meet very strict criteria for you to get that cash that you want. Most sperm banks lack diversity in their sample. So if you're a person of color or of an indigenous descent, your sperm might be worth more. So to summarize, sperm freezing can be somewhat of a security insurance, allowing you to live your life and work anywhere you want and experience all those adventures without worrying about fertility issues down the line. Before freezing your sperm, make sure you do your homework. Ask about accreditation, the licenses that the clinics have, the storage protocols, the payment, the storage fees, how they dispose the sperm when you don't need them, and sperm donation programs they have in place if you want to donate your sperm. You must also visit a clinic to have your sperm frozen. Although there are a lot of test kits out there that would allow you to produce a sperm at home, at the comfort of your home, and, you know, do your stuff at home, get it shipped in the mail. You don't have to go to the hospital and have that psychological depression when you're trying to produce your sperm in the hospital. So that's all from me today. Please feel free to share this video with a friend who might benefit from the content of this channel, and subscribe to be notified about my next video. Thanks again for watching, and cherish life.